Lord of Grant Hanley. We saw he came back from Scotland. There was talk of some shin splints issue.
Yeah.
What's the situation there? And obviously we're looking to tomorrow.
Yeah, it's not too bad. So he's available for tomorrow. So it was good, and it helped that he came back a bit earlier, and we were able to, have some treatments with him. And not too bad. He was able today to train with us, and he's available for tomorrow. It's just okay. Right now we know we have 5 games within 15 days that we have perhaps to be careful a bit with the load, and perhaps there will be a moment when we have to rest him a bit, because it's more like, some problems because of the load. No, not a big. Big injury, so I think the break in the summer will help to sort this completely out. Until then, when we have a period with many games, we have to be sometimes a bit careful with him, with the load, but he's available for tomorrow.
Nelson Oliveira had a calf issue, I think, so he wasn't available for Reading, has he?
Yeah, even much better. So he trained together with us since last Friday, the first time all together, and he was able to have all the sessions till then. And yeah, he's also back, and also some good news for him.
Lawrence Lightner, we've seen he's back in England, back here. Where is he in his recovery from his hamstring?
Yeah, he's there in his pen. We said so that Fulham is too early for him, and yeah, QPR will be a bit too soon as well. So we hope a bit that he's available for the next home game against Aston Villa then. And hopefully it works in the next day. So he's not far away, and is also doing some running stuff on the pitch. And yeah, hopefully we have him back for the next home game.
Alex Tete obviously looked very serious when he did it at Barnsley, but you sort of said before the international break, it probably isn't as your first feared. So where are we with Alex?
He's back. Also available for tomorrow. Also some good news. He trained the first time together with the team on last Saturday. So had right now several days with us, and yeah, also there for tomorrow.
Good news. Yes. Tom Tribal, where are we with him? You said ideally he should be back before the end of the season. Is he on course for that time?
Yes, he started yesterday with some running stuff, and okay, it will last a bit, so no chance for the next 1 or 2 weeks or whatever, but hopefully he can pretty soon then return back to a part of the team training, and then the full team training. And it looks like he's able to join us earlier than just in the preseason or whatever, so I'm pretty hopeful that he can play a few games before the break, and hopefully he can. So right now he's on plan. It's good.
Just an update on Matt Jarvis. Had a little bit of setback as he came back in the development game. Has he managed to now step up his training again?
Yeah, he's struggling a bit with some muscle injuries since this moment. So not too bad. Nothing with his former injury. It's more like that his body needs a bit time to adapt again to the team training. In the moment, he's doing some individual stuff, so I hope he can return back to our team training as soon as possible. So in this week and last day, so it was not possible. So I hope, it's a bit tricky right now because we have many games and there's not so much time on the training pitch, but I hope that he can return to our team training, or at least the team training of the under-23, perhaps if we're not there, because we are there perhaps with an away game or whatever pretty soon, perhaps anywhere next week. But it's more like a day-to-day decision with him, because his muscles are reacting right now to this load, and we hope he's back pretty soon.
So I mean, overall, that's a very positive injury bulletin. Is there any other guys, maybe the international boys who've been away, that might be an issue against him for tomorrow?
Yes, sadly, we have to do without Onel Hernandez. It's not good news, but he had some problems with the hamstring after the last game. There was in one of the last situations, he got a hit, and for that he stretched a bit the hamstring too far, and he gave me a sign that he wants to be substitute. And we tried everything to get him fit for tomorrow, but no chance. So in the first week of the international break, he did just some work with the physios and with rehab. So since yesterday, he's back on the pitch with some running stuff, but not in team training. And he's not available for tomorrow. And it seems like we also have to do against QPR without him. That's sad, because he was in a really good shape, and we all got the feeling in the recent games he was important for our game. Yeah, but it's like this, we have to end it.
But on our side, is that pretty much it? Anybody else?
No, so it's just a bit like a bit tricky with some lads arrived pretty late from the national game. For example, Marley Watkins just arrived yesterday. He wasn't able to train one day with us. Right now, he felt a bit today a bit a bit sick and tired because of the jet lag. So his national team, Welch, why ever they played in China, so 7 hours difference in the time zone. Why ever they had this trip to China, so it doesn't help us for this game. So it would be a little bit easier to have a game on Saturday or on Sunday. Then it would be okay. But yeah, I'm really thinking about to leave Mali out of the squad tomorrow because he had not so much game time in China, and then he felt really, really sick and tired a bit. And that's a bit tricky how to manage it. So nothing too special, not an injury or whatever. But probably will do without him.
Yeah, I was going to ask you about that in terms of how difficult is it to prepare the side for Friday when you've had quite a lot of boys away and, as you say, Marley's had to do a lot of travelling. From your perspective, that must be very tricky to prepare the team for football.
Yeah, it's, you have to find some smart solutions. So some guys returned back on Monday, like Grant Hanley, some on Tuesday, some on Wednesday, some on Thursday. So you get from day to day a bigger squad on the training pitch, but then you have to also to be careful how to handle it. For example, James Maddison played nearly 80 minutes on Tuesday, so you have to more to recover him than to train him with us. And several other lads, like Marcus Edwards, for example, had two games, so you have to be careful with him with load, because for him it was the first two games. Since several weeks, some guys arrive pretty late. It's always a bit tricky. It's also a bit tricky, so to prepare them for this Fulham game on the training pitch, because you have to differ a bit with the load. So some guys, for example, James and also Marcus Edwards did just some individual stuff, for example, yesterday. So it's always a bit tricky, but yeah, it's not an excuse. So it's for Fulham the same. So there were several players as well who were not available. So it's always a bit tricky. The first game after the international break, because you don't have the group all together and you can't prepare them, really focus and concentrate on this game. But it's like it is, and it's also the same for Fulham. And we don't use this as an excuse for tomorrow.